started award we did
no,
not ma'am
we
we
were
didn't
no.
complete
Ma'am, we were
everything.
speaking about inhalation
Ah,
and
inhalation.
breathing.
Yes. Okay. Okay, children. So, what do you mean by anaerobic respiration, Fidel? Anaerobic respiration means what, Fidel?
The process of breaking down of food glucose in the absence of oxygen. It occurs in organisms such as yeast and also in muscle cells of human being.
Okay, good. Okay. Next, Algus, give me the functions of respiratory system.
Ma'am, first supplies the food with oxygen and disposes carbon dioxide, filters impure air, produce sound, contains receptors for smell, rids the body for some excess water and heat, helps regulate blood pH.
Okay, so these are the, so we discuss up to blood pH. If there is some pH
yes,
level
ma'am,
comes,
we
already know. Yeah.
About the breathing.
Yes. So now we already know that respiratory system contains one process, that is breathing. So breathing consists of two cyclic phases. That is what we call inhalation and exhalation. So inhalation means what? Taking oxygen in or draws gases into the lungs. And exhalation, everyone knows. In exhalation, what we do? Giving out carbon
dioxide.
So now we are moving on to how. What do you mean by breathing rate of a human being? The next thing, breathing rate of a human being. The number of times a person breathes in a minute. Number of times. How many times you breathe in 1 minute? That is known as breathing. Breathing rate. So breathing rate of the one person is normally. Yeah, you can write down, which is I underlined. The number of times breathes in a minute is termed as breathing rate. And during breathing, two cyclic process, inhalation and exhalation. And a breath, that means one, what you call shwasam, we call it, no? So one breath means one inhalation plus one exhalation. So if you one inhale and one exhale, then only we can say that I took one breath. Breath is noun, breath. Okay. Breathing is a process, and one breath contains one inhalation plus one exhalation. Okay.
Can we write during breathing?
Yes. You can write all these points, because whatever I showed in the previous slide, I have put it over there. So you can write only this point. During breathing, inhalation and exhalation take place alternately.
Can we underline in the test?
Yes. If you have in textbook, those who are textbook can take it. Otherwise, you can write it. So why I'm telling you, why I am encouraging you to write it down. By writing, your memory is getting one booster. Okay. So once you read, you will not forget so easily. Otherwise, we will listen, we hear through this ear and we throw that other ear. So that's why I'm encouraging you.
Mom.
Yes.
Mama, we have to write all the last sentence. A breath means.
Breath is not necessary. You understand. But one breath means. One inhalation plus one exhalation. You can write it in short form, not exactly what I am writing. You can write it in short form. Those who are marking, you can write it. That is on page number 110. 110, the same paragraph over there, it is there. 110. You have got a picture. A girl is over there.
Yes, ma'am, we could see.
So on the above, the same points, that paragraph is given. Number of times a person breathes in a minute is termed as breathing rate. During breathing, inhalation, exhalation take place alternately. Okay? Yes. Now we are moving on to how do we breathe, or how this respiration process taking place, by learning the function of each part of the respiratory system. So this diagram, you will see it on page number 112. Those are textbook, please mark that diagram. That is for labeling. Okay, for your coming exam. this diagram will be given for labeling the parts. Okay, so it will be added to other diagrams what we have learned in the term one also.
Ma'am, can I share the page number in the text?
Figure 10.4, page number 112, page number 112.
Yes, ma'am, we see.
You saw? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am, we go.
Yeah, that figure. Only one figure over there is there. Okay. Okay, children, so we are going to learn the first part is nasal passage. The parts of the respiratory system. You can write the heading parts of the respiratory system. So what we are going to detail about only few parts, not all parts, pharynx, all that is there. That is, we are not going to discuss. Only the parts which I tell you have to write. First part, nasal passage. Nasal passage. Because oral cavity and all the part of food pipe. Okay, it's a part of digestion. So we are only dealing with the respiratory organs. One of the respiratory organ is nasal passage. Second respiratory organ is trachea. Trachea, or another word we call for trachea, windpipe.
Windpipe.
Yeah. For digestive system, you have food pipe. So here you have.
Ma'am, instead of food pipe, we say esophagus.
Esophagus. The first part, started dancing the board. Maybe my breath is moving it, I think.
The board is very sensitive.
Body is highly sensitive. That's why. So first part, nasal passage. Second part, trachea or windpipe. Why it is known as trachea? Because of there is a curly structure you will see on the top of it. Okay. So that is why we are calling it trachea. Or we call it tracheal tube also. Tracheal tube. So when you go to internet, you will see all this words, tracheal tube. So tracheal tube means, what does it mean? It is also
ma'am, can you write the spelling of
tracheal tube?
Yes, okay. Ma'am, tracheal tube.
Tracheal tube. So all these names are for one word, windpipe.
And
okay?
The third one is tracheal.
No. Second one is trachea, and trachea has two names. Windpipe and some of the internet we call them tracheal tube. Okay. Third part, lungs. I am not touching, it is moving somewhere. Third part, lungs. Then fourth part, diaphragm. Diaphragm. Fourth part, diaphragm. And fifth part, chest cavity. Chest cavity also has another name. Thoracic. Yeah, thoracic cavity.
Mom,
you got internet and all, we will hear this sound. We will see this name, thoracic cavity.
Ma'am, there is no chest cavity in the textbook.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah,
textbook in the chest cavity, but it is also known as thoracic cavity. which is we will be seeing in internet. Someone, those who got reference, you will be wondering, all the figures, everything is given thoracic, thoracic, and you will be wondering, ma'am, there is no word like chest cavity. Okay, that is what I am telling. This is for the people, those who are going for reference material at home, at in internet, you will see another word, thoracic. Okay, textbook, it is given chest cavity.
Ma'am, so that is textbook we can't see, ma'am.
It is in between the parts, what you call?
Yes, ma'am, but in the slide.
Some letters. On the slide, it is not there because this, it is there, chest cavity.
Ma'am, but I think it is added because in the textbook, it is not there.
And
for that, it is a different color.
So you can mark it in the textbook, okay? That pink color. This one side is closed chest, other side is open chest. That is how the diagram is shown. Okay. So you can add there in the textbook chest cavity, because without explaining that, I cannot go for lungs and other things. Okay. But in your textbook, go to page number 111. You will see there is a dark color they have given. Nasal cavity, lungs, chest cavity, diaphragm. That is the two, four things. Okay. That is why.
Yes, ma'am, but ma'am, in bold letters, chest cavity is given.
Yeah. So that means it is, you need to talk. So figure, they missed out, I think. They have shown figure 10.4 also. But in that, they are not marked. So that is why I added that over there. Okay. Yes. Textbook, it is given chest cavity, figure 10.4. But when you look at the 10.4, it is missing. So that is what I have added over there. So please.
Ma'am, we pronounce it as thoracic, right?
Thoracic. Thoracic. And or we also call it pleural cavity. Or we call it pleural cavity. That is also another name. Anyway, we speak in terms of chest cavity. This is for something you should not be confused. Because some students, ma'am, in the internet, there is something like this. What is that? So that is what I am trying to say. Okay. Yes.
Ma'am, on the left side, it is closed. And
right side, it is open.
And right side, it is inside the structure.
Yes, it is inside the structure. Okay.
Okay.
We are going to see, we will see one video, how these respiratory organs are working after explaining the function. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes. So we come to the names. What you have learned. So for labeling, you have to learn, even trachea is not mentioned in that, but when you go to that, what you call, page number 111, they have not given trachea, windpipe in bold letters, but that is also an important organ of respiratory system. Okay.
So that is why it is there in the figure.
Yeah, figure. So that is something is missing, that's why. And if you read that entire passage, no, they are using the word chest cavity, all that. Okay, here. So now shall we do one by one, what is the function of each part? So the first, as you see, the first picture, nasal cavity, actually, it is the opening of your nose. We call it nostril. So that is known as nasal passage. And what is mean by this oral cavity? Oral cavity is actually, it is your mouth. Okay. The opening of the mouth is known as oral cavity. Why it is mentioned here? The reason is that the foot pipe and wind pipe, they are connected to one side of the other. So once you look at it, you will see wind pipe. Other side is foot pipe. Okay.
Sometimes when we eat food, like when we move quickly, the food sometimes gets stuck in our windpipe.
The reason is, that is why we say, should not speak while you eat. So if you want to speak, you have to first digest the food in your mouth, and afterwards you have to speak. Otherwise, what will happen? The food particles will be fell inside the windpipe or trachea. Then you will have a choking sensation and you start coughing. And this is also part of a table manners. Table manner means you should not speak while the food is in here. Why? What will happen if you speak like that?
Ma'am, the food will get inside our windpipe and we'll have a choke.
Not only that, table manners means when you speak, the food particle will fell on other's face and other's food particle.
Yes.
Okay, that is table manner. I told you table manner, table mannerism it is. Okay, so if you are going for a function, we have to be very keep ourselves very decent and also part of a decency. Okay, not speaking or something like that. Yeah. So that is the meaning. And should not speak loudly while you eat the food. So that is also make you the food particles. Air will be, see, while you eat, you are breathing and breathing out. So because of the strength of the breathing, sometimes you will breathe that food also inside the windpipe. Okay, that is the reason. Then next is chest cavity. Chest cavity in Malayalam we call, have you heard about some of the old grandmothers, you know? Okay, so now what is important, that is why your chest cavity look like so many ribs around it. So what you see the surrounding, that the pinkish part, chest is that pinkish part, but there are something is surrounding it, that is the ribs. Okay, ribs of our heart. And you see our chest, inside chest so many things are there. And the right side, what you see outside part of the chest, I mean it's inside part of the chest, inside there are so many parts are there, that is what we are going to see. Okay,
chest
so,
excuse me ma'am, ma'am, chest cavity is called pleural cavity, means pleural is a kind of tissue, I mean tissue in our
yes pleural tissue, it is very soft and just like a sponge like a structure.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
wet moisture. Okay, so if you ever like those who are non-veg, no, you must have seen the heart of the chick. When you buy the chicken, you will get the heart of the chicken also. If you touch it, you can see to us what type of tissue it is. It is a very soft and pleuritic tissue. So these are the structure and function of respiratory organs. First one, nasal cavity. What is the function of nasal cavity? We inhale air as it passes through our nostrils into the nasal cavity. The function of nasal cavity is only breathing in and breathe out. That is the function of nasal cavity. Or inhale or exhale. I only written inhale. You can add exhale also. We inhale or exhale air and it passes through the nostrils. Nostrils means our two holes. Clear? That is nasal cavity. Now chest cavity, that is the word I used here. Thoracic or pleural is a space that is enclosed by the spine. It is not only, it is surrounded by our spinal cord, our breastbone and our ribs, and is separated from the abdomen. Abdomen means from the stomach structure by the diaphragm. So it is the space which is enclosed by so many protective parts: spinal cord, ribs, breastbone. Then breastbone means if you touch the middle of your heart, you can see the bone which is over there in the middle of the chart, very hard. So that is what we call breastbone or chest bone. Okay, then the chest cavity contains the heart. What are the things contained? That's why I told, no, why I said that some funny way about the celebrities. Usually you're if you really someone cries, you know, some people will die. Some old grandmothers, they used to beat their chest and they cry for the son and all. But some people go and hold their hands not to beat. Why? Because chest is very soft and sensitive. You should not beat or should not hit. If you just give one hit is enough, you will die sometimes. Okay. Why? Because the pumping of the heart, our life is in the heart. So pumping of the blood and breathing, everything is related to our heart. So a sudden hit or sudden bruise or something enough that person can die. So you never hit or never beat a person or never kick a person on his chest. That's enough, you can kill a person. Why? Because
also when we hit on the middle also we will die.
Yeah, middle also. Yes, why? Ma'am. It contains the heart, thoracic aorta, lungs and esophagus. All these parts are connected to the chest cavity. Even esophagus is little more above, but it is also connected to a chest cavity. Then only it come to the abdomen. So chest cavity contains the heart, our heart, thoracic aorta. Aorta is the major blood vessel. So next class you will be studying, next chapter, transportation, we have that one, what you call for the circulatory system, you will be learning aorta and all. So thoracic aorta, lungs, our lungs is another important thing, and esophagus, food pipe. So these are the things, important part of chest cavity. So you need to, it should be protected. So that is why ribs are covering the chest cavity, so that to help, it should be it will help, the ribs will help to protect the, in protecting the heart from sudden accident or sudden heat or some people. And there are cases due to the intensity of the accident, there are these ribs will break and it will be enter into the heart, that people, yes, will ma'am. Die, you know, they will die then and there is no way. So that is why that much very sensitive and all. And you can see the first slide, I am showing how the outer side of it, how well it is protected. And in the middle you will see the heart, the middle of that what you call the windpipe trachea, the heart is lying down, liver is there. It is not only heart, we also have a liver connected to that. And then we have, this is the sideways of that that chest cavity. And you can see there's an arch like diaphragm, arch like part which is just holding this chest cavity. It is known as diaphragm. Okay, so that is about chest cavity.
I will write down.
No need, you can just understand. Okay, you read it or you go to internet also, little man. The third next part what we are going to learn is lungs. Okay, lungs. So lungs, what is the main function of the lungs? The main function of the lungs is the process of gas exchange or respiration or breathing. So that is done by lungs.
Ma'am, can you zoom in?
I zoom in, but let us become blurred, I think. But still, can you see?
Ma'am, want to see that figure, ma'am.
Okay. You want to see the figure. Yeah. So, just to see the figure, the lungs has got three parts, okay? Not simply. There are two lungs, right lung and left lung, okay? And we have three chambers. In your textbook, the name of the chambers is not given because in 8th standard and all, I think you will be studying about it. But when you take the picture from the internet, no, these things will be there. It is only to understand, this is first chamber. We call it chamber. Some of the slides, internet thing, it is shown is, it is as three chambers. So this is the first chamber. And this one is second chamber, and down there is a third chamber. So the first chamber of the lungs, we call it superior lobe. Another word, lobe. Lobe means a chamber. Okay. This is all scientific terms. Chamber usually we use.
What is the meaning of lobe again?
Lobe is the chamber. Chamber, Malayalam we call ara.
Yes, ma'am.
Nilavara, will you say Nilavara, the underground cell of the old houses, ara.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that is the meaning of chamber. Okay, so in scientific term of chamber is lobe, L-O-B-E. Okay, lobe. So the first chamber, we can call it as superior lobe. Second chamber of the lungs, we call it as middle lobe. And third one, the last one, we call it as inferior lobe.
Okay.
This is only for knowledge. Okay. In your textbook, it is not given detail about only chambers they have given. They have mentioned the chambers. So that is what I have brought this slide to you to have a better understanding of the structure of the lungs. Okay. Oh, gone. Oh. I think that is gone somewhere. Okay. No. Don't write that. And I will tell you what to write. Okay.
We can.
You can have it. One minute, children. Let me just make it. No. 1 minute. Let me come move it. Okay. That's enough now. Little more.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. I'll just make it a little shorter, otherwise you will not. The main function of the lungs is the process of, you can write that one. The main function of the lungs is the process of gas exchange or process of respiration, breathing. And the same thing it is repeating. In respiration, oxygen from incoming air enters the blood and carbon dioxide, a waste gas from the metabolism, that is our immune system, leaves the blood. So while oxygen enters, carbon dioxide leaves the blood. A reduced lung function means that ability of the lung to exchange gases is reduced. So if your lungs is not normal, what will happen? You will have asthma. The sickness very common, asthmatic patients. What is the problem of asthmatic patients? Their lungs may not function normally. So that is the reason for it. So if the lungs is not okay, our entire metabolism will not occur. So what does lungs do? When oxygen enters in the blood, the lungs will release the carbon dioxide. That is, we get it from the waste material of the food and all. While you eat the food, there will be nutrients. The useful products converted into nutrients, unwanted products, some of the unwanted products turn into solid matter. Some will be turned into liquid matter and some will turn into gas matter. So gas matter is the one in the form of carbon dioxide. Gas matter is carbon dioxide. Liquid matter is our urine and you know waste matter is our feces. Okay. So, yes.
The first part of the main function of the lungs is process of gas.
That you can write it down so that you will get a little bit, when I come to on Monday, you will not forget. Okay. So main function of the lungs is the process of gas exchange or respiration or breathing. That exchange of gas exchange, what you call respiration or breathing. And what is happening there when we inhale, the oxygen will enter in the blood. Okay. And the gas waste matter, that is carbon dioxide from the food, that will be removed, released when we exhale. Okay.
Ma'am, so what about the down functions?
So this is some of the, in your textbook, it is only mentioned about your breathing. Breathing is the main function. But apart from this, we have so many other functions. In addition to gas exchange, the lungs have a number of metabolic functions. Metabolic functions means the functions related to our body system. Okay. Metabolism means our body is a material. No? We are a material. So the things which is related to our body, we can call it in chemistry metabolism. No, biology, we call it metabolism. So other function is, one is defense mechanism. Defense mechanism also is the function of lungs. Defense mechanism. So those are not able to see that. This is for your knowledge. If you want, you can write. Otherwise, it's okay. Maintenance of other functions of lungs. Maintenance of water balance. That is how much water required for our body. That is also done by our lungs. Next is regulation of body temperature. Okay. If you are having fever, what will happen? Your breathing also will change, body temperature changes. That is also related to the function of lungs. Regulation of body temperature. And last one, metabolism, biologically active. Our 1 minute, I just shift it a little bit. Okay, the last, this is all extra functions, metabolism of.
Mom, the functions that you write the same of the
Yes, functions. Yes, the same thing I am writing separately because some of them may not able to see it clearly because of blur. It is coming blurred.
Oh yes, ma'am.
That's why. 1 minute. Let me. Biological metabolism of biologically active substances. That is about all that what we require for our body, nutrients and waste material. All this is done by lungs. One is defense mechanism. That is something which our body feel it or sense it. Okay, which is in danger, or maybe some virus is entering in your body. Okay, some kind of virus is entering in your body, then the lungs will show the sense that symptoms first. That is why something will happen to their pressure level and all that. So that is the means of defense mechanism. It will try to defend the body. Lungs will try to defend the body against the attack of viruses which is entering in your body. That is why it is turning into fever. Actually, fever and all these symptoms of some dangerous virus or bacteria enter in your body. Okay, that is the mean. So defense mechanism, the lungs will sense fast and it will show the variation first. Then only doctor can check it, and they will check your heartbeat first. Correct? Whenever you go to the doctor, whenever you go to the doctor for any sickness or fever or something, what does doctor say first? Checking your pulse rate. Yeah. Yes, checking your pulse rate, whether it is a normal or not. If it is not normal, then he will know that there is some sickness on your body. Then he started do the so many tests, blood test, that test, this test, to identify the things. Clear? Second one, maintenance of water balance. That is how the water which is required body will be retained, other water will be changed into other form. The regulation of body temperature, of course, the fever, and when there is no fever, how do you identify? By touching your head and by checking the heartbeat.
Yes, ma'am. Our body will be hotter than usual.
Yes, yes. And sometimes there is blood circulation is not there, then your body become cold also. Correct. That is, yes, also ma'am, part of a identifying it. Metabolism of biologically active substances, like that some poisonous substance enter in your bloodstream by breathing, because of suppose you are living in a polluted area, there's a chances of poisonous gases can enter in your lungs. So that also diagnosed shown by the lungs first. So that is why. Yes.
Yeah, my sister have class now. Can I
leave? Yeah, I am also now winding up the class. Almost time up now. 1:40. Okay, children. So we are winding up the session.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Only how many students total?
Ma'am, 40. Ma'am, I think there are some 39. Other students from other class also.
Okay, fine, yes, fine. Ma'am. No problem. No problem. The some 8C students are sitting in the class, I think. Okay.
Yes. I think some other students.
Ma'am, yes. Maybe they have class in the
school. I have taken 2 minutes extra. Okay. That is why. Okay. I just taking the camera clip to understand your presence. Okay, children. Bye. We will meet on Monday. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Read this chapter and learn this much. Okay.
Okay, bye-bye. Ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.